वागीशाद्या सुमनसः सर्वार्थानाम् उपक्रमे यन्नत्वा कृतकृत्यासु तं नमामि गजाननम् गणानागन्त्वा गणपतिगं हवामहे कविं कवीनाम् उपवश्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान् शृण्वन्नोतिभिस्सीदसाधनम् या कुन्देन्दुतुषारहारधवला या शुभ्रवस्त्रान्विता या वीणावरदण्डमण्डितकरा या श्वेतपद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युतशङ्करप्रभृतिभिर्देवैः सदा वन्दिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेषजाड्यापहा. वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू दि फाइनल एंड कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट ऑफ माय डिस्कोर्स ऑन दि सिंस एन्यूमरेटेड इन अनुशासनिक पर्व. In the 24th chapter of Anushaashanika Parva, Yudhishthira asked Bhishma Pitamaha the following question. Idamme tatvato rajan vaktum arhasi bharata ahimsa itvapi katham brahma hachya vidhiyate. Oh, the emperor, you please tell me, you have the capability to answer my question even without murdering a Brahmin. Even without torturing a Brahmin, how can the sin of murdering a Brahmin, Brahmahatya Patakam, the sin of murdering a Brahmin, will still be attached to any person? Please tell me. And this question is answered by Bhishma. Why this special question? Because Brahmahatya is supposed to be the ultimate of the sins, in addition to being ungrateful. So, Bhishma said the following actions, even though that is not killing or murdering a Brahmin, will still attach the sin of Brahmahatya. I will narrate them now. Brahmanam swaimahuya bhikshardhe krushavittinam bruya nastiti paschat tam vidyat brahmagatinam. Inviting a Brahmin specifically to receive bhiksha or alms from the person, and then when he arrives, reneging on that word and sending the Brahmin back with empty hands, that will attach the sin of murdering a Brahmin.
Madhyasthasyeha viprasya yoma chanasya bharata vrutti marati durbuddhi tambijyat dhammagatinam.
Taking away the livelihood of a Brahmin who is not inimical to the person or just neutral to the person, taking away the livelihood of such a Brahmin who is not inimical to you and with evil intentions, that will result in the Brahmahatya to the person.
Gokulasya trushartasya jalardhe vasudadhipa उत्पादयति यो विघ्नं तद्विद्यात् ब्रह्मघातिनम्.
इफ द काउस आर अबाउट टू ड्रिंक वाटर टू क्वेंच देयर थर्स्ट एंड समबडी कम्स इन द वे एंड टेक्स अवे द वाटर आर इन सम मैनर क्रिएट ए हर्डल फॉर द काउस टू ड्रिंक द वाटर टू क्वेंच देयर थर्स्ट दैट पर्सन विल गेट ब्रह्महत्या पातकम्.
यः प्रवृत्तां श्रुतिं सम्यक् शास्त्रं वा मुनिभिकृतं दोषयत्यनभिज्ञाया तं विद्यात् ब्रह्मघातिनम्.
दिस् ईज् समथिङ्ग् वी आर् सीयिङ्ग् एव्रिडे. क्रिटिसैजिङ्ग् दि आर् बिलिटिलिङ्ग् दि वर्क् आफ् महर्षीस् लैक् दिस् पुराणस् वेदास् ज्योतिष्य वास्तु आर् एनी आफ् दि थिङ्ग्स् रिलेटेड् टु वेदास् अण्ड् दि epics authored by the Maharishis without reading them and criticizing them unfairly. We see every day this is happening in India. A famous lawyer came on TV and said he doesn't consider Rama a good husband. He did not read Ramayana. And then one chief minister jokingly said, did Rama construct a bridge? Which engineering college he read? These are the actions, these kind of actions, criticizing the epics, criticizing the shastras authored by Maharishis unfairly without reading them, that will beget the person with Brahmacharya Patakam.
ఆత్మజాం రూపసంపన్నాం మహతీం సదృశేవరే నప్రయచ్చతి కన్యాం తం విద్యాద్ బ్రహ్మగాతినం.
దిస్ ఈస్ అప్లికబుల్ టు దోస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ నాట్ మ్యారీయింగ్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ డాటర్స్. వెన్ ది డాటర్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ గుడ్ లుక్స్ ఆర్ ఆర్డినరీ లుక్స్, షీ ఈజ్ నాట్ అగ్లీ ఆర్ షీ డజ్ నాట్ పొజెస్ సచ్ క్వాలిటీస్ విచ్ ప్రివెంట్ హెర్ ఫ్రమ్ గెటింగ్ మ్యారీడ్, మ్యారేజబుల్ డాటర్, అండ్ ది ఫాదర్ డజంట్ ఈవెన్ ట్రై టు గెట్ దట్ డాటర్ మ్యారీడ్. Once this female's working has come into the, has become a normal practice, I am seeing more and more families not getting their daughter married off in the right age. Of course, the government itself has made rules which prevents us from marrying the daughters at the right age, that is before completing the 8th year. At least whenever the marriage is allowed, at that time we should get their married. We are keeping them off under some pretext or the other, like education, doing PhD or doing job. She needs to have some free time before getting marriage and delaying it and not finally getting married. There are a lot of spinsters moving around in the society because their parents have not married. And in all such cases, the fathers will get the sin of killing the Brahmin. Marriage of the daughter is the prime responsibility of the father. The father cannot hide behind the excuse of my daughter is not ready, she is still doing education, she has just joined the job, or my wife and daughter are not agreeing on the matches, or something, any excuse. Father cannot hide behind any excuse that a person has reason. Doesn't condone the act of sin. Sin is sin. Reason, or with reason or without reason, with proper justifiable reason or unjustifiable reason. Not marrying the daughter is a great sin, and I did not say this, and I am not saying this. It is said by Bhishma Pitamaha, on whose saying the India was administered by Yudhishthira, and 174 generations after him, India or Hindu Rashtra is governed by those principles. They were implemented for nearly 3000 years before the Kuru Vamsha has been defeated and taken over by Nanda kings. So this is a very great sin, and becoming commonplace, this needs to be refrained from.
Adharma nirato moodha midhyavai dvijatishu dadyat manmagatim marmatigam shokam tam vidyat brahmagatinam.
An idiot, a fool, or a person who does not have any respect on the Vedas and the righteous conduct as specified in the Vedas, and he creates such grief for the Brahmin that will pierce their vitals, a deep grief to the Brahmins, that person will get the sin of Brahmacharya, no doubt about it.
చక్షుషా విప్రహీణస్య పంగులస్య జడస్య వా హరేతయో సర్వై సర్వస్యం విద్యాత్ బ్రహ్మగాతినం.
ద పర్సన్ హూ స్టీల్స్ ది బిలాంగింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ బ్లైండ్ పర్సన్స్, లేమ్ పర్సన్స్, డంబ్ పర్సన్స్ హూ కెనాట్ స్పీక్, అండ్ ది పర్సన్ హూ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు మూవ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ డిసీజ్ ఆర్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ being in a hurt position because of injury or whatever. When people are in that condition, if you steal whatever the person has, that will result in getting the Brahmahatya sin.
Ashrame va vane va api grame va yadiva puriye agnim samusra janmohat tam vidyat brahmagatinam.
The people that cause arson, that is setting fire to the houses or ashramas, either in the forest or in the villages or in the towns or cities, whoever causes fire, sets fire intentionally and causes fire accidents resulting in burning down of multiple villages or multiple houses or even a single house, whosoever it may belong, that person is begetting the sin of Brahmacharya. In chapter 45, there are two more slokas which describe great sins. Yo manushya svakam putram vikriya dhanamichyati kanyam va jivitarthaya yakshulkena prayachyati saptavare mahaghore niraye kalasahvaye svedam mutram purisham cha tasmin mooda samasya samashnute. The person who sells his son. See, these people who are taking dowry at any cost. You know, dowry is misunderstood in the Hindu society today. It has been banned. Dowry is something that the parents of the bride give to the bridegroom voluntarily. What makes them give dowry to the son-in-law? See, according to Hindu tenets, when the father dies, the property is divided equally among the sons, and the property right is not given to the daughters. But that is a wrong impression, because when a marriage is performed, the daughter's share of property is given to her husband at the time of marriage itself. That is why after the death of the father, that is when the daughters are married off, they don't get a share. So this dowry is something that is the share of the property of the daughter given at the time of marriage. And if the father has some property, the girl gets dowry. If the father has no property, the girl does not get dowry. But insisting on dowry, exceeding the property share of the daughter, that is something selling the son. When the people give dowry on their own, there is no sin. But if you demand dowry, which may exceed the share of the daughter in the property at the time of marriage, afterwards if the father earns more property, the daughter has no stake on it. So the dowry itself is something that the father of the bride gives away at the time of marriage. But exceedingly it's demanding, which exceeds the share of the property of the daughter, that is a great sin. That is called selling this son. Similarly, the bridegroom has to pay a price to the father for begetting her, giving birth to her, for bringing up her up, and giving the daughter away permanently to that person. When you take something from somebody else, its price has to be paid. So it is incumbent on the bridegroom and his family to pay a fair price for the bride, and that is called kanyasulkam. Even if you take dowry or not, if the father gives dowry or not, people have to pay the price of the bride, kanyasulkam. We are not paying. That is a sin on the part of the bridegroom and his family. Even in Ramayana, Janaka, the father of Sita, specified the price of his daughter. He said, Virya Sulka, that is the price for giving my daughter away, Kanya Sulkam, is the valor and Virya. That is the price. Rama has that, so I am giving my daughter. That is the price he set for his daughters. He gave two of his daughters to Rama and Lakshmana and two daughters of his younger brother to Bharata and Shatrughna. He specified the price, and the price is that. Whatever price the father of the bride asks has to be given. I will make another video on the marriage and its proper rules or something, which are specified in this Anushaashanika Parva sometime later. But right now, take it from me that the bride has to be paid, the bride's father has to be paid a price for giving the daughter. And the dowry that is given by the father needs to be accepted by the bridegroom. He cannot demand. bridegroom or his parents cannot demand, they cannot even ask what dowry you are giving. Rama or Dasharatha did not ask what dowry you are giving, but Janaka gave a lot of dowry without being asked, because it is her property. So who sells the daughter or the son for money? Yes, they beget great sin. How much sin? They will reside in 7 narakas. There are 21 narakas. Out of 21, they will be suffering punishments in 7 narakas. And what will they eat? They will have to drink sweat, perspiration from the bodies, and urine from the people, and also the excretion, poop of the people. They will be made to suffer this by selling the daughter or by selling the son. Not getting the daughter married, again I have told you a little earlier, that is equivalent to murdering a Brahmin.
Pashyam kumarim bharataha etam samupabhunjate ete papasya kartara tamasyandhecha sherate.
Pashyam kumarim bharataha. Using your strength, maybe monetary strength, positional strength or physical strength, tam samupabhunjate rapes her, enjoys her comprehensively. That person will fall into the naraka, which is completely dark, and he may not have sight. He may lose sight in the same birth. If he escapes this birth, next birth he will be born as a congenitally blind person. Rape is not excused by the shastras. That is what Bhishma stated. These are not my statements. These are Bhishma statements instructed to Yudhishthira, who implemented all this. Rape is heinous, and there are punishments. That person will lose eyesight. So friends, with this I conclude my discourse on sins. I have narrated the sins as given in Ramayana. One video, I have made 3 videos on the sins narrated in Garuda Purana, and I have made 3 videos on the sins narrated in the Mahabharata. Of course, there are many sins, and we can commit them in many ways. The best way is not to commit. But once you have committed already, like you have already crossed before you saw these videos, or before somebody told you, they have to be cleansed. Is there any way for the cleansing the sins which are committed without knowing that it is a sin? Yes, they are there. They are easy methods, and I will be narrating those resolutions in my next video. Until then friends, take care. Swasti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahim mahisha go brahmanebhya subhamastu nityam lokas samasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshati parjanya prithvi sasyasharani desho yam kshobharayito brahmana santa nirbhaya putra putrinasantu pautrinah adhana sadhanasanta jivantu sharadam shatam. Om purnamadaha purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva avashishyate. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. May you all be blessed.